Welcome to AR Statement Setup and Processing. In this course, we are going to cover how to send out through either print or email accounts receivable statements. Okay, so we're going to navigate to accounts receivable, print or email statements. The first three boxes here are default sender information that you want to use when sending out your statements. So to customize how you want the sender to appear, you're going to come into Accounts Receivable Configuration, and you're going to go down to the area that says Contact Settings. So right now it's based on the user profile up here, whoever signed in. If you would like a standard profile, no matter who was signed in, you can do something like this and fill that in. Okay. So those three fields will change if you put default information in there. The marketing text and message text fields are not used frequently. Any sort of messaging or marketing you would like to put on your accounts receivable template, you will do that when you customize your statement. Deliver to all available email addresses. If that is checkmarked, that will send an email to the primary and secondary email addresses listed in the customer information page. So on your customer record, on the main page, your primary and your secondary email addresses will get statements sent to them. So if you need multiple, more than one email address, you can do a semicolon here, just a little tidbit there. Okay, so it'll go to all three of these emails. Start date and end date would be filters for your transactions that you want to print or email. Or the current month reporting period, prior month, and any listed in this dropdown. You can base your transaction dates on the invoice date or the due date as well. Okay, scroll down. The statement type, you can pick either open items or balance forward. The from customer and to customer could be a range of customers that you would like to send statements to. In addition, you could pick a customer type, or instead, you could pick a customer type as well. The show all transactions would be showing all invoices, adjustments, advances, overpayments, every type of transaction would show on the statement. If you don't have that checkbox on, it only includes invoices and adjustments. There's some more checkboxes here to show all but reverse payments, show customers with no balance, but if they had activity in the time period selected, or if customers were flagged as inactive but had activity in the date range selection up here. I'm going to scroll up to the top for a minute. Now, let's say you just want to see a very broad range of any statements for any customers based on last month, for example. Okay, so this would be a very common scenario. Not very many filters turned on. They might do it based on due date. But when I hit view, it's going to list out all of my customers. I can pick and choose which ones I want to send it to. So while you can use filters and such, just pointing it out, it's not completely necessary. You still can pick and choose on the next screen what you would like to do. Okay, so here's where you're going to pick your actual statement that will be the PDF document, either printed out or emailed out as a PDF attachment, and the email template, if you're using the email functionality, of the actual wording that you're going to put in the body, the subject of the email. And then you would also want to put a statement date down here. These title fields at the bottom are not used. Okay, now we're going to hit view. And you can see some customer statements that have pulled up. I also have my email addresses from the customer records that have pre-populated in as well. Now notice, all of these were pre-checked as printed. So if I went over to a specific customer and I want to email as the default instead, I'm going to go to their additional information tab and change my statement and invoice delivery to email or to both. Okay. So let's say we just want to look and see what a statement looks like. So here's an example of a PDF that would either be printed or emailed, depending on what you pick, to be sent out. Again, this can be customized in the Customizing Printed Document Templates course. Okay, so be sure to watch that course to be able to understand how to customize those printed document templates. Okay, so if I want to just email this one out or just a few, I would just click the check mark on which ones I would like. I can also do this as well. Okay, so you print your email, it's going to send the one out and it's going to print those to a separate window. So I'm going to hit this. I've got two statements were sent to Adobe. And then I can print a hard copy. One statement has been scheduled for email delivery. Okay, so here's my two statements. One went on the third page. There's my two statements. And then I'm going to go show you where the email delivery log is. So it is housed company admin email delivery history. Okay, you can see the statement sent here. Can hit view if you want to look at more details. And it says it has been successfully sent. So that is the process to send the accounts receivable statements via print or email. In order to get to customizing the statements, so they would be in the printed document templates. Again, watch that course on how to customize printed document templates. You can come in here and edit your and change your various statements, okay, which that course will cover. Okay, then your email templates are going to be here. There's another course for that, customizing email templates, that will show you how to fill an email template out for the body of the email. Okay, so how to use these fields and how to fill this out and use the email templates. And then here is an actual statement, email template, along with the printed document template, the statement that was sent. So I can make the subject up here say whatever I like in the email template. I can make the wording say different things as well. And then the printed document template, which is the statement PDF, can be customized to how you would like it. You could put a logo on, you could change columns and such as well. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. Otherwise, enjoy sending out your accounts receivable statements.